हेलो एवरीवन, ओपन योर हिस्ट्री एंड सिविक्स बुक क्लास 8 लेसन 4 द यूनाइटेड नेशंस। अर्लियर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड अबाउट व्हाट इज द यूनाइटेड नेशंस, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द यूएन, एम्स एंड प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द यूएन, इनिशिएटिव्स टेकन बाय द यूएन एंड द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ द यूएन। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द यूएन। Now, before starting today's topic, let us recall definitions in the cross question answers related to the previous topic. First of all, definitions: the United Nations, treaty, organization, apartheid, human rights. And now answer these cross questions. Where is the headquarters of the UN? What is the main aim of the UN? Name 5 permanent member nations of the UN. Tell any 3 initiatives taken by the UN. And tell any 3 limitations of the UN. The topic of today is the structure of the United Nations. That means we are going to discuss pages 159 till 162. And the objectives of today's topic are, you will come to know about 6 principal or main organs of the United Nations. And these 6 organs are the General Assembly, the Security Council, the Secretariat, the Economic and Social Council, the International Court of Justice, and the Trusteeship Council. In today's video, we will learn about the first 3 organs of the United Nations. That means we are going to learn about the General Assembly, the Security Council, and the Secretariat. And we will learn about these organs under the following headings. What is it? Headquarters, members, when it was formed, and the functions. Now, before discussing about these organs, let us discuss the new terms related to today's topic. New terms: the UN system. The organs and agencies of the United Nations are together called the UN system, the General Assembly, the World Parliament, the Security Council, the decision-making body of the United Nations, the Secretariat, an administrative body of the United Nations, budget, an estimate of income and expenditure for a set period of time, veto power, authority to reject something that has been proposed. Charter, an official document which describes rules and regulations. Now, let us start up with the reading. All will open page 159 of the book, the structure of the UN. In order to achieve its aims, the UN has created several organs and agencies. They are together called the UN system. That means the organs and the agencies of the United Nations are combiningly called the UN system. They work under the supervision of the UN. The United Nations has 6 principal organs. Principal means main. The General Assembly, the Security Council, the Secretariat, the Economic and Social Council, the International Court of Justice, and the Trusteeship Council. Now let us discuss about the first organ of the United Nations. That is the General Assembly. The General Assembly. What is it? The General Assembly is the main body of the United Nations, and it is also called the World Parliament. Parliament means law-making body. That means the General Assembly is the law-making body of the world. Headquarters. Its headquarters are located in New York City in United States of America. Members. Representatives of all the member countries. And we had already discussed that at present there are 193 member countries of the United Nations. And every member country can send at least 5 representatives or delegates to it. Next, meetings. At least once in a year. The General Assembly meets once a year to discuss the ways to deal with the international matters. Next, when it was formed. It was formed on October 24, 1945. Functions of the General Assembly: to discuss the world problems and settle them peacefully. Second, to pass the annual budget of the UN. And the third function is to elect the Secretary General of the UN. Now all will open page 161 of the book. The General Assembly. The General Assembly is the main body of the UN. It works like a world parliament. All member countries are the members of the General Assembly. Each member has one vote. Thus, the principle of equality of all the nations is applied in the organization of the General Assembly. As we had discussed, the representatives of member nations attend the meeting, and every member nation can send 5 representatives or delegates to it. But at the time of voting, one nation can cast only one vote. It elects its president for every session. The members of the General Assembly elect a president and 21 vice presidents at least 9 months before the opening of the session. And Ms. Vijayalakshmi Pandit was an Indian politician who was elected as the first female president of the General Assembly in the year 1953. Decisions are taken on the basis of the majority votes. Basically, decisions are made by 2/3 majority on the important matters like electing non-permanent members of the Security Council, admission of new members, suspension of members, etc. The General Assembly meets once a year to discuss ways to deal with international issues. Special sessions are held during times of emergency. But an emergent session of the General Assembly can be called anytime. And the General Assembly can discuss and suggest solution or give advice to any issue in the world within the limits prescribed in the Charter of the United Nations. The Assembly presented the Universal Declaration of Human Rights on 10th December 1948. And the authority to grant the membership to a nation lies with the General Assembly. Functions of the General Assembly. First, passing the annual budget of the UN. Budget means an estimate of income and expenditure for a set period of time. That means the main function of the General Assembly is to pass the annual budget of the United Nations and to fix the share of each member state to pay. Second, discussing issues affecting international peace and security. Issues means matters. And it is also the duty of the General Assembly to draw the attention of Security Council whenever it finds that the peace of the world is endangered by the action of one or more nations. Third function, admitting new members on the recommendation of the Security Council. Recommendation means suggestion or advice. As Security Council is the decision-making body, so for admission of any of the new member nations in the United Nations, the General Assembly has to take advice from the Security Council. Next function, electing the Secretary General of the UN. That means the Secretary General of the United Nations is appointed by the General Assembly on the recommendation of the Security Council. Next function, electing the 10 non-permanent members of the Security Council and the members of the Economic and Social Council. That means it is also the duty of the General Assembly to elect the members, especially the non-permanent members of the Security Council and the members of the Economic and Social Council. Now, I hope the General Assembly is clear to you. Now, let us discuss the second main organ of the United Nations, that is the Security Council. Now, the first question arises, what is the Security Council? The Security Council is the most powerful body of the United Nations. And it is also known as the executive body of the United Nations. As all the important decisions of the United Nations are taken by the Security Council, that is why it is also known as the decision-making body of the United Nations. Second, headquarters. The headquarters are located in the New York City of the United States of America. Members, it consists of 15 members, out of which 5 are permanent members. And those 5 permanent member nations are France, Russia, America, China and England. And 10 are non-permanent members. and those 10 non-permanent members are elected by the General Assembly for the 2 years on regional basis, and no country can be elected as a member immediately on the expiry of its terms. Next, when it was formed, the Security Council was formed on October 24, 1945. Now, the main functions of the Security Council. First, it is responsible for maintaining international peace and security. Second, recommends the entry of a new member of the United Nations. Third, it can order military action against a country which persists in disturbing the peace and security. Now, let us read the Security Council from the book. The Security Council. The Security Council is called the executive wing of the United Nations. Executive means law implementing. Earlier we had discussed about the General Assembly, and the General Assembly is a law making body of the United Nations, whereas the Security Council is a law implementing body of the United Nations. It is the most powerful body of the UN. It deals with matters of war and peace. It consists of two types of members, permanent and non-permanent. Means overall there are 15 members in the Security Council, out of which 10 are the non-permanent members and 5 are the permanent members. And the non-permanent members are elected by the General Assembly for 2 years on the regional basis. And each member of the Security Council has one vote. And there are 5 permanent members: China, France, Russia, UK or England, and USA. They enjoy the veto rights. Veto right is the right to reject and is exercised by a permanent member. That means the negative vote of the permanent member is called veto. And veto power or veto right is an authority to reject something that has been proposed. And the council is powerless to act if any one of the permanent members uses the veto right or the veto power. It means even if one of the permanent member is against any resolution or decision in discussion, it will not be passed by the UN. Non-permanent members are 10 in number. They are elected for a term period of 2 years by the General Assembly. And these members don't have the veto power. That means the veto power lies in the hands of the 5 permanent members of the Security Council. So we can conclude that Security Council can be crippled by the exercise of veto power by any one of the permanent members. So the veto power is like the heart trouble of the United Nations system. Now let us read the functions of the Security Council. Functions. First function, can order military action against a state which persistently undermines the peace and security of the world or by bilateral talks. That means if any nation is continuously harming the peace and security of the world, the Security Council can order the military action against that country or nation. And secondly, the Security Council can advise the bilateral talks. That means the Security Council can advise them to talk amongst themselves to sort out the issue. Second function, settles disputes between nations through peaceful means. Third, imposes economic sanctions against nations that do not follow its directions and orders military action as a last resort. That means if any nation is not following the rules or the directions of the Security Council, then Security Council can put the financial penalties or the fines on that particular nations. And then too, if the nation is not following the directions or the rules of the Security Council, then the Security Council can take the military action in the last. Next function, recommends the entry of a new member of the United Nations. Recommends means advise or suggest. Next point, on the call of the General Assembly, it expels a country from the membership when a nation does not follow the UN Charter. Means if the nation or a country is not following or not working according to the UN Charter, the Security Council can remove that country from the membership on the call of the General Assembly. And the last function recommends the name of a person for her or his appointment as a Secretary General. So we can conclude that the foremost responsibility of the Security Council is to maintain peace and security in the world. Now the next is Secretariat. Now before reading the Secretariat from the book, let us discuss the main points related to the Secretariat. The first question arises, what is the Secretariat? The Secretariat is an administrative body of the United Nations. Headquarters. Its headquarters are located in the New York City of the United States of America. Members. About 10,000 staff members are selected from the different member countries of the UN. And as the international employees, they have to take an oath that they will not receive any instructions from their own country. They all will work under the guidance and command of the Secretary General. And they help the United Nations to carry out its responsibilities as best as possible. When it was formed in 1945. Functions. Supervises the functions of the UN. That means the Secretariat performs the day-to-day activities of the United Nations. Interprets speeches and translates the documents to the official languages of the UN. Third function. Organizes conferences. The last. Prepares details of the meetings. Now let us read the Secretariat from the book. The Secretariat. The Secretariat performs the day-to-day activities of the UN. It is headed by the Secretary General. She or he is appointed by the General Assembly on the recommendation of the Security Council. She or he remains in office for a tenure of 5 years. That means he or she is elected for the 5 years. At present, Antonio Guterres is a Secretary General of the UN. Her or his duties include mediation in the disputes between nations and supervision of the UN forces. That means the main duty of the Secretary General is to solve the disputes among the nations, and he also acts as a leader of the United Nations. And Antonio Guterres became the Secretary General in 2017. Before that, he served as the Prime Minister of Portugal from 1995 till 2002 and the UN High Commissioner for Refugees from June 2005 till December 2015. Functions of the Secretariat. Supervising the functions of the UN. The Secretariat performs the day-to-day activities of the United Nations and supervises the functions of the United Nations. Organizing conferences and preparing minutes of the meetings. That means whatever is said in the meeting, the Secretariat has to maintain a written record of each and everything. Third, mediating in international disputes. That means to maintain the international peace in the world by solving the disputes of the nations. Interpreting speeches and translating documents to the official languages of the UN. That means all the important documents are translated to the official languages by the staff members of the Secretariat. So we can conclude that the Secretariat is the administrative wing of the United Nations, and the United Nations has been able to solve many international disputes and stop wars with the help of its main organs. Now I hope the first three organs of the United Nations are clear to you all. And your today's homework is to make a chart on the organs of the United Nations, in which you have to mention organ's name, what is it, when it was formed, headquarters, members, and its functions.